This Disney DVD is enhanced with Disney's FastPlay. Your movie and a selection of bonus features will begin automatically. To bypass FastPlay, select the main menu button at any time. FastPlay will begin in a moment.
Pictures presents The Little Mermaid.
Oh my gosh.
For the first time ever on a two-disc special edition DVD.
Sing with me now.
The adventure. The fun. The music. The classic story.
Is in love with a human.
Disney's The Little Mermaid.
Yes!
Winner of 2 Academy Awards.
That's right.
Someday I'll be part of your world.
For the first time ever on a two-disc special edition DVD. October 3rd.
What a soft shell I'm turning out to be.
Allow me to shed some light on the subject.
This spring, 2 of the world's greatest minds are in a race to create the most astonishing invention ever imagined.
To be amazed.
One is in it for the glory.
I invented it. Me.
The other.
Where are we going?
To find the family he's never known.
This family's a little different.
Now, here's what you gotta do. You gotta help me find my teeth.
Walt Disney Pictures presents Meet the Robinsons.
I haven't slept in 8 days. I've got the caffeine patch. Each patch is the equivalent of 12 cups of coffee. You can stay awake for days with no side effects. Sorry.
Coming to theaters this spring.
The fun of learning continues with the Disney Learning Adventure Series on Disney DVD.
What a terrific idea!
It's 2 new learning adventures.
My goodness!
Winnie the Pooh Shapes and Sizes and Winnie the Pooh Wonderful Word Adventure.
Wow!
First, your kids will discover all the shapes and sizes in the 100-acre wood.
It's spectacular.
And they can have fun with the magic of words.
Definitely.
Absolutely.
Let's go. What will we discover? It's Disney Learning Adventure Time.
Developed by Disney and leading educators, kids can discover the magic of learning.
Could you teach him?
Yeah, Rabbit, would you please?
Your preschoolers will want to watch these fun lessons again and again.
This is
It's Disney Learning Adventures, Winnie the Pooh Shapes and Sizes, and Winnie the Pooh Wonderful Word Adventure. Coming soon to Disney DVD.
It's Disney Learning Adventure Time.
In the classic tradition of the beloved Disney films Bambi and Lady and the Tramp, comes an extraordinary tale of an unlikely friendship.
I'm a fox.
I'm a hound dog.
The Fox and the Hound, 25th Anniversary Edition DVD.
Come on, let's have some fun.
With restored picture and sound. Critics call it superior, a landmark Disney film. Walt Disney Pictures proudly presents The Fox and the Hound 25th Anniversary Edition DVD.
You're my very best friend.
Share it with your family this fall. And look out for Disney's The Fox and the Hound 2, an all-new movie premiering on Disney DVD Winter 2006.
Get ready for the biggest adventure 5 little pups ever had. So run, don't walk, for Disney's all-new adventure, From the doghouse to your house. Air Buddies, the all-new movie, coming soon to Disney DVD. This time, it's all in the family.
Who's Nita?
She's a girl. I used to know.
Who needs girls?
The legend of Brother Bear continues in an all-new movie. And these guys...
How's it going, eh?
Beauty, eh?
...still don't have a clue.
It's that time of year, eh?
Spring fever.
Yeah, you know, like the birds.
Yeah, and the bees.
And the moosets. Bye! Oh, we gotta go work out.
Yeah, gotta keep these muscles real buff, eh?
Come on!
This summer, no matter how hard they try to get along...
We're still getting the brush up from those moosettes.
So we thought we'd appeal to their olfactory senses.
Ew.
I got news for you, little brother. That wasn't mud.
Guys and girls are totally different animals.
Bravery. That's what really impresses the ladies.
Every goes for himself. Oh,
act like we're not here.
That went well.
From the great north comes a new adventure.
You are the wisest shaman.
Sha-woman, okay? Wise and man don't even belong in the same sentence.
Brother Bear 2.
I'm a hoof man. Yours are nice and shiny.
Hoof man. Why didn't I think of that?
All new on Disney DVD this August. Little girls know them. Little girls love them. Now see the Disney princesses come to life like never before. Introducing Disney Princess Fairy Tales Volume 1. All new princess stories featuring Aurora and Belle. Here's a sneak peek at the all new Sleeping Beauty story.
I have a surprise. I'm throwing Philip a birthday party. What a wonderful idea.
Oh, we'll need to decorate the ballroom.
Oh, and choose a menu.
Oh. Music.
Oh, and party favors.
I'll pick the theme. I'm going to make you a dress for the surprise party.
But it has to be our little secret.
Can you keep a secret?
I'm making you a dress.
Oh!
Disney Princess Fairy Tales, the first volume in a brand new Princess Legacy. Coming soon to Disney DVD.
Coming to Disney DVD.
The zoo will officially be ours in 3, 2, and...
showtime.
What a strange place for a party.
Ow!
When one of their own is taken away.
Dad!
Ryan!
Help me!
Ryan! No!
We've got to find my son.
Okay.
Here I come. Who put that bar there?
Five friends will take on a mission.
Do I look trashy in this?
Ow!
By land.
Run!
We are going to die!
By air.
Bet you didn't know I could ride geese, did you?
Bareback. By sea.
Help, 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 help! Oh, dear. Anyone got any eucalyptus wipes?
And discover...
Who are you guys?
We're covert agents.
Oh! You're the worst covert agent ever!
Ow! What a jungle the city can be.
Everybody, stay calm.
You and your crew here are a little far from your burrow.
Far from your burrow!
They're frighteningly horrible monster beasts.
But they're not bad dancers.
Walt Disney Pictures presents...
I got Ryan sent! Ryan!
Doesn't anyone knock anymore?
The Wild, coming soon to Disney DVD.
Playhouse Disney presents a whole new 3D look for a whole new generation of preschoolers. Mickey Mouse Clubhouse.
See ya real soon.
Only on Playhouse Disney. To me, sweet as can be, baby.
Step right up! Now you look like the perfect contestant to test your knowledge of circus animals. Is this your first circus? It is? Boy, are you in for a treat. Step right up and spin the wheel. Here's how it's done. Just press enter on your remote control to make the wheel spin. When the wheel stops, you'll be asked to identify the animal that you've landed on. Use the up and down arrows on your remote control to move through the choices. When you're ready to make your selection, press enter on the remote control. If you're right, I'll tell you all about that circus animal. If you want to leave the game at any time, press the exit button. Go ahead, give the wheel a spin. Good spin, yes sir. Now, which circus animal is this? One, a zebra, two, an elephant, or three, a panther? That's right, this is an elephant. And at the circus, these massive animals are trained to perform all types of lifting and balancing tricks. Elephants come from Africa and Asia. At the circus, you'll most likely see Asian elephants who have smaller bodies, smaller ears,
look at his ears,
and shorter tusks than African elephants. See their tough, thick, wrinkly skin? It's actually covered in hard-to-see hair. And while they can't technically run, elephants can walk up to 20 miles an hour, which is faster than Olympic hurdlers.
Don't forget that we elephants have always walked with dignity.
So are elephants really afraid of mice? Nah, if they saw one, they'd probably ignore it. Unless it was Timothy Q Mouse, of course. A fine spin indeed. Now, what have we got here? Is this number one, a bear, number two, a monkey, or number three, a dog? Bravo, you're correct. This is a bear. Ever see a bear dance or ride a unicycle? At the circus, you might, though they'd probably prefer to take a nap. During the winter, the brown bear hibernates between 4 and 7 months.
How do you like that?
Bears normally walk on all four legs, but they can stand up on their hind legs. Not to prove they're taller than you, but because they want to get a better look around them or take a better sniff. Because while their eyesight is not that good for faraway objects, bears have a great sense of smell. Great spin! Now, which one is it? Number one, a seal, number two, a badger, or number three, a pig? Correct! This animal is a seal. Actually, there are two main types of seals, those with ears and those without ears. At the circus, you'll see the ones with ear flaps.
Oh, ear!
All seals live in the sea, but only the eared seals can rotate their hind flippers forward so they can get around on land. They can stand on their front flippers and can perform all sorts of tricks, from balancing balls on their noses to playing instruments, as long as their trainer continuously rewards them with some tasty fish. Look at that wheel spin! Good job! And what we have here is either one, a horse, two, a cow, or three, a parrot. Please tell me which is correct. Horse is correct, of course. Well done. Horses are splendid, well-trained animals that help out in the circus with style. In fact, horses have always been a great help to humans.
They certainly are.
Cowboys would ride them in the Wild West, warriors would gallop into battle on them, and royalty would have their coaches drawn by horses. Today, there are over 150 different breeds of horses. They are large, strong animals with solid hoofs, a long mane, and a long tail. A male horse is called a stallion, and a female horse is called a mare. Baby horses are called foals and can stand and walk within the first hour or two of being born. Thank you. Aha! Great spin! Now tell me, is this 1, a snake, 2, a hippopotamus, or 3, a chimpanzee? Perfect choice! This is a chimpanzee. Chimpanzees are members of the ape family. Now, to avoid confusion, they are not orangutans. And they're not monkeys. Monkeys have tails. Chimpanzees certainly do not. And they're definitely not gorillas. That's better. All right, chimpanzees have pink or black faces, long black hair, and no tail. And they like to swing from branches and trees, but mostly get around walking on all fours, although they can walk on two legs for short distances. So please try not to confuse them with other apes. Good spin! This is one of three animals. It's either 1, a chicken, 2, a rabbit, or 3, a tiger. Very good! This is indeed a tiger. In the circus, tigers are called cats, but these are no ordinary kitties. The tiger is the largest wild cat in the world and can be found prowling the jungles of India and the forests of Asia and Siberia. Its reddish-orange coat is covered with black stripes, and did you know that no two tiger stripes are the exact same pattern? Tigers need 13 pounds of meat every day.
Look, I can't eat in peace.
And a tiger's roar can be heard as far as 2 miles away. So they'll let you know if they're hungry. Now look what you've landed on. Is this 1, a sheep, 2, a walrus, or 3, a kangaroo? Please make your selection. Well done. Kangaroo is correct. Kangaroos come from Australia, and sometimes you'll see them at the circus. These animals are marsupials. The females have a special built-in pouch they use for carrying their young. Kangaroos have large, powerful hind legs and long feet used for leaping. They can hop up to 40 miles an hour and jump over obstacles up to 10 feet high. Kangaroos are feisty animals. And to defend themselves, watch out, they kick. A terrific spin, outstanding. And you've landed on a very interesting animal. Okay, is this 1, a turtle, 2, a lion, or 3, a mouse? Please make your choice. Well done! This is a lion. Lions are quite friendly with each other and normally live in groups of 15 or more called prides. In prides, the females do most of the hunting and cub rearing, while the male lion defends the pride from predators.
What a temper!
His mighty roar is so loud, it can be heard by humans more than 5 miles away. Not only does his roar scare off intruders, it also helps round up stray members of the pride. The male lion is the only member of the entire cat family that grows a mane around its head and is royally known as King of the Jungle. Congratulations! You've spun the big wheel, tested your knowledge, and had a chance to meet some of the amazing animals here in the circus. Come back again anytime you want to take another spin and visit your animal friends.
Hi, kids. Welcome to Dumbo's Big Discovery. If you want to read along, here's how you read.
Hiya, kids. Remember me? I'm Timothy Mouse, here to introduce you to the world's greatest elephant in Dumbo's Big Discovery. Hope you have fun reading and playing along.
Dumbo's big ears made him different from other elephants. His mother knew he was special. But the other elephants laughed at him.
Hey kids, click on the elephants and the animals on the train to hear what they have to say.
Only a mother could love those ears.
Look at those ears. Aren't they funny?
Jumbo. He should be called Dumbo.
We think your ears are cute, Dumbo.
Your mother's right. You are special.
Oh, don't listen to them.
One day, Dumbo and his friend Timothy Mouse,
that's me,
met a baby kangaroo who did not laugh at Dumbo's big ears. The little kangaroo showed them his big feet. Then he showed them what his feet could do. The kangaroo asked Dumbo what he could do with his big ears.
Click on the kangaroo to hear what he has to say. And don't forget about the animals on the train.
My big feet are for jumping. What are your big ears for?
I'm a tiger, and I have funny stripes on my fur. They help me hide from other animals.
I'm a giraffe, and I have a really long neck. It helps me find food.
I am a gorilla, and my arms are longer than my legs, so I can swing from tree to tree.
Dumbo remembered that his ears could keep him warm and dry. The little kangaroo felt that Dumbo's ears could do more. And Dumbo discovered that his new friend was right.
Remember to click on the animals on the train to hear what they have to say.
You're the best!
Hooray for Dumbo!
You can do it, Dumbo.
Dumbo learned that his ears could help him fly. No one laughed at Dumbo's ears after that. In fact, everyone agreed that Dumbo was pretty special.
Liked our little story, and don't forget, it's what makes you different that makes you most special.
Hi, kids. Welcome to Dumbo. When you're ready to move on in the story, click on the forward arrow. If you'd like to go back in the story, click on...
To me, it's a movie that's got everything.
It's charming.
So original.
Terrific. Exotic.
Perfect.
Really, really emotional.
Amazing.
Great characters.
Phenomenal animation.
It's just gorgeous.
Colossal, stupendous.
Wonderful songs.
Colorful.
Entertaining, with a capital E.
It makes me cry.
And then there's the plaid one.
It's got everything.
I did you, Dumbo.
Ask people who they love Mickey Mouse and, you know, Minnie Mouse, right? And they immediately go to Dumbo as their most beloved Disney character.
Dumbo was put into production very quickly and apparently moved through production more easily and with greater speed than I think any other Disney animated feature.
Because the story was simple, the crew was very small, with that kind of a setup, it's easy to get into a flow.
The animation streamed out of their fingertips like lightning onto the paper because the idea was so clear and simple.
But it feels like everybody was having fun and just enjoying themselves in the sense that it wasn't trying to sort of break through and be the Citizen Kane of animation. The animators could just sort of enjoy what they were doing.
My memory of it is that it just appeared there all of a sudden. You know, I was not conscious of people working on it as I was with all the other early films, Fantasia and Pinocchio and Bambi, and of course Snow White.
And in the middle of all that is this nice, sweet, little candy-colored Dumbo. It's short, it's sweet, it's very straightforward, and I think it gets taken for granted.
You don't think about it when you're looking at it, but it is only 60 minutes long. And movies aren't supposed to be 60 minutes long, you know. It's just odd length in a lot of ways. But it doesn't want to be any longer than 60 minutes.
It is not pretentious. It is not overwhelmed with production value. It's charming, it's beautifully made, and the relationships touch everybody.
It is so entertaining, with a capital E, and represents so many of the Disney values we've kind of grown to love and accept.
And fortunately, because it wasn't an enormously expensive picture, and that it was relatively short, it made money.
When it was released, the public just ate it up. This is what they wanted from Walt. The public didn't really want Fantasia. Walt wanted them to try it out. He wanted to lead them on a different path. But what they wanted, I think, was something more like Dumbo. Just pure entertainment.
You know, it's not a movie that looks like Snow White did or Bambi did. It's not very complicated to look at.
If you look at the backgrounds, they're very, very loose. They're almost gestural, some of them. Those tents, those big tents, I mean, they're just a wash of color, basically.
It's just real big, simple shapes, almost like a kid's coloring book in a way. And the music sort of carries you along, and boy, you get right into this thing where Dumbo is the outcast.
Is it possible?
Isn't there some mistake?
Just look at those E-A-R-S.
How many kids grow up feeling, this part of me doesn't look right, I don't fit in, I'm not part of this group, this part of me is ugly? Right away, you identify with that little character. And I think every kid at some point has to feel that.
you can layer all your emotions on him because he can't speak for you. And somehow when it is so symbolic like that, you say, here's a little outcast who nobody loves because he has big floppy ears and he doesn't even talk. Suddenly you can pour all of your life experience by the bucketful into this character and start walking through the movie in his shoes.
Isn't it amazing that it can be such a beautiful little film and your main character doesn't say one word?
Dumbo does not speak throughout the whole film, and this is quite a challenge to the animator who did it.
You know, that is such a non-dialogue beginning, anyway, before Timothy shows up. Very, very little dialogue. It's just visual bonding with mother and child. It's really beautifully done.
And you'll even relate to him more because he doesn't say a word in the story.
It's all acting, and you understand everything that little character is feeling. I think that's really good animation.
And then for him to find Timothy Mouse, obviously, who is actually smaller than him, but the big shot, you know, and then the talker next to the mute guy, it just is such a great dynamic that they develop.
Look, Dumbo, I'm your friend.
And when Timothy comes in and says,
what's the matter with his ears? I don't see nothing wrong with him. I think they're cute.
You just love him for that because he's being picked on. And it's something every little kid can relate to is, you know, we all have features that get picked on. And you really wish you had, you know, somebody to come up and take care of those bullies for you.
He is just your ultimate buddy and is trying to make the world around Dumbo understand, look, this guy is a good guy. You know, just because he's handicapped doesn't mean he's bad.
You ought to be ashamed of yourselves. A bunch of big guys like you, picking on a poor little orphan like him.
And it makes for a terrific contrast. You have this little, sweet, sad elephant, and then Timothy, who's the optimist, who said, we're going to show them, come on, you know, I'm going to help you. So they just make a nice team, a nice buddy team, those two.
Oh, yeah, you're terrific.
You just really appreciate the ones that are protecting him.
So you like to pick on little guys, huh? Well, why don't you pick on me?
Jumbo. You mean Dumbo. Dumbo.
Bambi's mother is a very good mother, but Mrs. Jumbo really kicks it, you know. And when her little kid is getting picked on, she goes to work and just starts throwing people around and rearing up. And you just love that elephant, you know, because she's protecting little Dumbo, probably even more naive and innocent than Bambi in some ways. And then she goes through almost more emotionally than anyone in the movie, too. I want my baby. She gets her baby. The baby gets torn from her. She gets locked away. So she's really going through tremendous emotion in this picture.
You know, Elmar ain't crazy. She's just brokenhearted.
All aboard, let's go.
Here's one of the most beautiful trains in it that were ever animated.
That one shot of it coming into town when it introducing that.
You know, it starts out with that map of Florida and the little railroad train and you know, that whole Americana, the circus is coming to town kind of a thing, which, although the circus is a European invention, we sort of, the Ringling Brothers and Barnum and Bailey kind of adopted it and Americanized it.
Well, to me, it's a very uplifting style. The colors are very bright. You deal with the folklore of the circus, clowns, acrobats. The whole world of the circus is very colorful.
You know, I look at it too in historical perspective because the circus to us now, today, sitting here in the new millennium, is kind of a romantic notion. You know, most of us have probably seen a circus, but it doesn't come to town every year like it used to. And if you lived on a farm and you didn't have a TV, which you didn't, you had a radio, and when the circus came to town, it was a big deal because how else were you going to see an elephant? How else were you going to see a tiger?
One of the reasons I think I love Dumbo so much is it makes me cry.
All-time sweetest scene in the world is
absolutely amazing of how you feel for those two at that time.
But the animation, I mean, one of the absolute best moments in animated history.
And go home and be cradled by somebody.
To me, it's a movie that's got everything. Heart, imagination, humor, great characters, wonderful songs, and that eye-popping, unbelievable
thing goes. It's truly an inspired sequence.
You know, there's a section in there where you're only, it's weird.
It's bizarre, you know. I love the thinking on it. To go, I just love the idea of that. It turns into such a lovely moment.
And then there's,
I think it's a needed contrast to all the sadness going on because
pink elephant sequence, I want to see it. because I still have it. I think it is one of the greatest sequences ever put on film by anybody anywhere.
I like to study. I want to know what he did and how he did it. The comedy in it is so terrific. But that little dance that they all do, it's one of those animation showpieces that you want to see over and over again. There's a nice change in their character development as well, because they're kind of nasty and mean at the beginning, but Timothy is able to turn...
The whole thing about the magic feather doesn't show up until almost at the end.
He triumphs in the end, and he can fly, and he's the star of the show. You triumph somehow, and you...
Yourself.
It is probably the simplest Disney story for a feature ever.
Dumbo is... That's Dumbo, really. They're just telling the Dumbo story in a different sort of way.
There's always beauty in every aspect of a person. And for me, that's what that little story is all about. Acceptance. And finding the very thing that you dislike the most about yourself and realizing it's something to celebrate.
People on, and I'm holding the magic feather and I don't know.
Anything that saves the day someday.
Favorite Disney movie.
Walt Disney's Disneyland, the story of Dumbo. Now, here is your host, Walt Disney.
From time to time, people ask me, which is the favorite of all the pictures that we've made? Well, it's the one that you're going to see right now on this program. The story of the little elephant with the big ears, Dumbo. From the very start, Dumbo was a happy picture. It really started from a very simple idea and, like Topsy, just grew. We weren't restricted by any set storyline, so we could give our imaginations full play. In other words, if a good idea came to us, we put it in the story. It was really a happy picture from the very beginning to the end. As our story begins, we discover Mr. Stork on his way to the winter quarters of the circus with a package for a certain Mrs. Jumbo.
Oh.
To view an image full screen, use the directional arrows on your remote.